All right. Okay. So we're here with the Ensoniq ASR-10. And before we even get started, thank you so much for joining me here on NTSC Pal. Your interest in the usage and the understanding of synthesis through these old things here. Very much appreciated. Glad you are here. Now, I've been toying around in my brain with the idea of arpeggiation with envelopes and what way to do it than on the Ensoniq ASR-10. So what am I talking about here? Well, first, let me show you. We're going to start with waveform B28 from the Carpenter Sawdust, which sounds like this. Right? So this is just a singular waveform. Well, a layered waveform. And what I wanted to do, I just am really coming to be more enamored with arpeggiation, which the ASR-10 does not do. So the goal always when you're challenged with these sort of things that your instrument doesn't do is to figure out how to get it done. Once you have the tools, you can emulate or create something that in most cases is far more interesting than what you were thinking about anyway. So anyway, what I'm getting at here is that I thought two things. One, I needed something that would repeat itself over and over and over again, like an arpeggiation. So when you hit a note, say you want to go arpeggiation, right? I just want to hit one note and have something move along like that. So the only thing that, well, there's two things. The only things that repeat on the ASR-10 and subsequently the Trilogy samplers is the LFO, which you know, and envelopes. They can be set to repeat. So then I thought, well, what if I take pitch and just put it on the on an envelope to follow the envelope and then have it repeat, which would carry a note off its main pitch, right? So let's see if I can get there and do that. So first I want to attach the envelope to the pitch. So I'm going to show you what I did because I've already did it, but I'm going to show you how I got there. And you can do this with anything if you are, well, that has the tools, if you're in a pinch or if you want some creative sort of movement that's repetitive. So first I'm going to deal with the pitch envelope of this here. So I do this. Which is get the pitch envelope in the mix for this waveform. And once it's here, I can set its value. So I don't know what it's set at right now on the raw pitch, but we'll see what happens. So right now the pitch is moving along with the waveform. I want it to actually do something more interesting and I want it to repeat. Right now it's just running through its envelope. So let me see if I can get it to repeat and just stand by while I tinker about. So I've just put it on repeat mode and it'll probably take a long time to repeat with that sort of waveform. Let's see what we get. Repeating, right? Pretty standard, nothing special, right? So now that I have it repeating, I need it to sort of segment itself. Right now it's just looping, but it's not breaking up. I needed it to sort of break up like an arpeggiator would, like it's sort of playing different notes. That's when the LFO comes in. I can use an envelope to turn on and turn off the volume, so it gives the appearance of notes being played individually, but in reality, that's what's happening. I mean, police siren, right? So let me get the envelope in the mix, right? So I'm going to, and before even that, like the most ideal envelope to use is sort of a square wave, because a square wave is just on, off. It's on, off. Sound familiar? Note on, note off. Note on, note off. Square wave is the way I'm going to go. So I'm going to go to the envelope section. I got a square wave in the mix. And now I'm going to attach that square wave to the amplifier or the volume, so that when I play it, I should get on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off, right? All right, let's see if this turns out the way I want it to. Stand by. All right, so LFO. Ah, one more thing I have to do. This is advanced stuff. Stuff you really wouldn't have to do on a regular sampler, but because of the ASR-10 and its many curves that you can choose, I got to set the right curve. Stand by. Success! Right. So now we have it cutting off based on the square wave. So it kind of sounds like an LFO, but super fast, right? Let me slow it down. My arpeggiator. Now, from here, you can take more creative direction to it. So what I ended up on mine is this right here. I ended up with this. Which I'm going to use. The next song I work on, I'm going to use this because it's really cool the way the LFO. And here's the thing now. That you can hear, I've caused the LFO to speed up and slow down because I've modulated the LFO rate with something else, with another envelope, so you can get all types of crazy stuff. Really cool stuff. So let me go back to our original one. See if I can make it fun. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make this one polyphonic, because right now it's monophonic. That's no fun. Let me make it all polyphonic. Okay. Let's slow it down and see what we get. Oh, I'm starting. I gotta restart the envelope so that they all start at the same time. Let's try again. And then now I can take the LFO and control how it behaves by modulating its speed. Now, what if I modulate it with the same envelope one, just for convenience? So I'm modulating the LFO speed with the same pattern that I'm modulating the pitch. Let's see what we get. That sounds no fun either. Let me see something else. Oh, you know why? Because I'm modulating the wrong thing. I don't want the depth rate. There we go. Let's try that again. All right, here we go. Check this out. Way too fast. It's looping, so that's going to be no fun neither. It's just keep on resetting itself. Let me use another envelope. Let's see how this turns out. That sounds better. Let's get it more exaggerated. Just a little bit more exaggerated. Let's see. Let's try this. There we go. Let's push it. Right, so we're in the ballpark, and of course I like the one that I made. I spent some time on much better. I think that's so cool. I wonder what some effects would sound like. I don't think delays would sound good, but I can't help myself. I just can't. Let's see what it sounds like. That's way too busy. It seems like I like the original the best. So that is how you really create an arpeggiated sound. Now, I didn't spend that much time, but you can really go in and make it repeat in an actual sort of melodic pattern, because once again, you have such an advanced envelope on the ASR-10, and of course the 16 plus and the EPS, that you can make the pattern be any pitch you want. And then of course, once you start adding the LFO modulation to that, you could even get more fun stuff going on. But that is how you sort of think outside the box. Everything is synthesis, and you can create so many things just by thinking about how to get something done when something isn't apparently there. There's so many things on this particular sampler that I would like. Like, I'd like a resonant filter. Of course, I have the Waveboy disc, so you could just get one. But, you know, that's got me thinking about, well, how can I create a resonant filter on the... Actually, it's so easy now that I think about it. You could just use the EQ effect and modulate that. You can create stuff with the tools you have as long as you think about the elements that make up where you want to go. A resonant peak is just that. Now, you can create a resonant peak with a parametric EQ. And because with the ASR-10, you could modulate virtually anything, you could just take that resonant peak and move it about by attaching it to something movable. But that's how you think outside the box. And I would encourage you that no matter what sampler you get on, think outside the box. Connect things in your brain to get an outcome that you like by thinking about the sampler's core tools. That's how you get the most out of these things, because believe me, the first thing you would think about is like, okay, well, I need to get something else, right? You could, of course, but it's much more interesting when you create something in elemental form by attaching things to something and sort of thinking outside the box. You get an interesting sound because at that point, it's not another instrument doing it that was meant to do it. You're doing it with something that wasn't meant to do it. And the ingenuity comes from your thoughts, right? That is all I think I want to share for today. Again, thank you so much for joining me here on NTSC Pal. Your interest in this sort of stuff, very much appreciated. Of course, the old stuff isn't as obscure as it used to be. It's very much in vogue over the past few years, but nonetheless, the advanced sort of applications with these is very much appreciated on my part for you. I will catch you on the next one. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.